Hello there, all you beautiful thrill seekers. My name is Coach Sheldon Stubborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to a theme park newsroom update where today we're going to be looking at the next major refurbishment of a ride or attraction at Thorpe Park Resort. I've got two in mind, as well as talking about what could happen. Now, before we get started with all of this, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, click the notification bell so you never miss a YouTube video. Comment down below your thoughts and opinions as well as your questions for the 2K sub Q&A video, which has been released the day before Christmas Eve. Use the hashtag question before or after your question. Also, guys, go into the description down below where you can submit your video ideas using the Google Forms link. They're all being saved, they're all being noted down, they're all being viewed. Also, guys, you can now go into the description down below. You can check the other videos yesterday and over the previous few days as well, where you can actually see that we've got a new link in the description down below, as well as the usual Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, and Snapchat, as well as the Google Forms link. And that is to join the Discord server. Yes, we're on Discord. So if you want to join the chat, I won't be voice chatting a lot because I've got a lot of work to do. I'm a very busy man. Got a lot of stuff to do, but if you want to chat with other fans on the channel on the Discord server, then the link is also in the description down below for that one. I may have linked it in the about section of the channel by now as well, so double check there, but it will definitely be in the description of the videos from now on. And also, guys, make sure you stay tuned because we've got plenty more content coming over Christmas and the new year period. And for now, guys, let's discuss the two rides in question which I think could be under major refurbishment work in the next few years at Thorpe Park Resort. So let's kick it off like a football match, and ride number one in question is Derren Brown's Ghost Train. Now this, it also has Walking Dead the Ride circled next to it, and I'm going to talk about that in a little bit. But the main ride in question for this one is Derren Brown's Ghost Train. Now let's talk a little bit about Derren Brown's Ghost Train. This is a multi-sensory dark ride experience based by the illusionist Derren Brown. It opened originally in 2016. Loads of problems with it, loads of inconsistencies in reliability of the ride, and in 2017 they added Rise of the Demon. It made it a bit better, but to many people it was still on and off. So this ride's been very on and off since it opened. It's been, to many enthusiasts, this has been Merlin's biggest waste of money, apparently. Now, when it works, when it 100% works, it is amazing. It's an incredible dark ride and well worth it. But when it's inconsistent nearly all the time, when it's 50-50 on and off, and when some of the effects don't work, it doesn't feel like a complete ride. You need something more effective. You need something that's going to be, working pretty much 100% of the time, unless it breaks down all of a sudden. And, it does feel like a big waste of money. I think the price tag of it is definitely not the price tag I would pay for what it's delivered over the last few years. Of course, 2021, it celebrates 5-year anniversary in 2021, the original. So you've got to think about it and say 5 years, that's, a long time. The fact that it's been going almost or pretty much as long as Subterra, and Subterra, it's had its marketing failures, it's had its bad reviews, it's had its negativity. But Nemesis Subterra was not a bad a ride as Derren Brown's Ghost Train when that's working 50-50. When Nemesis Subterra is running at full capacity and Derren Brown's Ghost Train's working 50-50, Subterra is a better ride in my opinion. So you sort of put the question to it as to how long would you give that ride? And I would say not that long in my opinion. I'd keep the queue line, but I think the rest of the ride could pretty much go. And, when I'm talking, obviously you've seen the title of the video, the fact of major refurbishment, overhaul, refurbishment, removal and replacement. That's what we're looking at here. So I think the way to majorly refurbish the ride is to pretty much, if Derren Brown's not going to be involved anymore, give it a brand new storyline, give it a whole new experience, and give it a brand new ride system. I would give it a brand new ride system, and this brings into the question Walking Dead the Ride. Now, many people have said, bring it back to X or just get rid of the ride altogether. Imagine, if you tore down the Walking Dead pyramid and you extended the building at the back of Derren Brown's Ghost Train, you ripped out the entire Derren Brown ride system, you had the queue line, then you had the pre-show bit at the start. Imagine you took the Derren Brown stuff out, extended the building and took out the ride system. Imagine what you could have. I'll tell you what you could have. You could have what Movie Park Germany are doing for next year at their park. an indoor, multi-dimensional family thrill roller coaster in the dark. So it would fill the void of Walking Dead the ride, and also it would bring a whole new lease of life, a consistent new lease of life, to the Darren Brown building. Now this, again, this talks about the refurbishment of the ride, giving it a new ride storyline, giving it a new ride system in the same building. That is what I would do. Look at what Movie Park Germany are doing with the Hollywood in Germany style, you know, multi-dimensional Intamin roller coaster. And Thought Park have worked with Intamin before. It's been a while since they worked with Intamin. You know, I think we're looking at Stealth Days here in terms of coasters. But, you know, you've got to look at that and say, well, Intamin can still work with Thought Park. And I reckon Thought Park are going to be a big candidate for a coaster in the next few years. Now, again, look at Movie Park Germany's new coaster for next year as an example. I think that that, with the right level of theming, with the right level of projection mapping, modern technology in the building, not on the ride, no VR. I'll be checking every day to see if there's VR on this ride, and I'll be using the VAR system to see if they've snuck in any VR goggles into the building and try and catch them with my refereeing skills. But yeah, I definitely think that no VR, no way Jose, and sorry to the people who are called Jose out there, but yeah, no way, no chance, no VR at all. And I would just go with the usual multi-dimensional coaster system, nothing to do with the coaster at all. I would just, in terms of technology, do the projection mapping, give it a good pre-show, give it a nice original storyline as well. You know, we're in the dockyard area, get rid of the Walking Dead stuff, and give it an original horror family theme. I think that would be the way forward for this potential investment. So I think that that is what they could do, and I think that this would be an incredible ride experience if they did that. Ride number two, the final of the two, on your screen already. It is, of course, Rumba Rapids. It's had a very big history. The Thunder River, the Ribena Rumba Rapids, the Rumba Rapids, of course, now it's known. It's gone through many different changes, many different new soundtracks, etc. Now, this is another ride I would do. And I think with this one, you have to look at what America's been doing with their rapids rides, especially Knott's Berry Farm, with the changing of the Bigfoot River Rapids into Calico River Rapids, or Calico River Rapids. I think that's how it's pronounced. You look at what they've done with their rapids rides, and you look at what they've been able to complete with them, and you look at that and say, well, hang on a minute, Conga River Rapids needs that, but I tell you something now, Rumba Rapids needs that just as much. And you know, it's one of those things really where it needs more theming, it needs more bigger storyline, it needs bigger detail, and I think it just needs an overhaul refurbishment, if you will. So I reckon the Rumba Rapids could be a big refurbishment order. However, I would definitely see this as a potential candidate for a major overhaul refurbishment. So I think in terms of the storyline, I think I'd like to go with something a bit more, not dark, but I think horror jungle. I think that's what I'd do. I'd maybe go for like sort of a deep water passage in the hidden jungle woodlands, shall we say, kind of theme. With the spirits of the woods haunting the jungle, woodlands, river and stuff like that. And sort of mix it in with like a dark jungle theme and a bit of Mystic River Falls storyline thrown into it from Silver Dollar City. I think there's a real challenge and a potential with that. So I think this would make it a really good ride experience. And I know that people say, well, we need Thought Park needs a new coaster. They need a new coaster. Of course they do. They need it in a good few years. I think Thought Park needs a new roller coaster. It's nearly 10 years since the Swarm. They do need a brand new roller coaster, in my opinion. I do think that. But if you're looking for major refurbishments to rides while we're waiting for it, Rumba Rapids is a prime candidate. And I think you could do some cool stuff with this in terms of storyline, theming, animatronics, technology, new effects, just stuff to make it better, just stuff to make it a whole lot better ride experience. And I reckon Thought Park could do that. You look at the theming in the queue line for Darren Brown's Ghost Train when it first opened, and you look at theming elsewhere in the park, you look at the stuff they did with Angry Birds, and you know, you look at the theme they did with that, and yes, it's a family area, but they did a lot of theming with it. And you look at the landscaping around different rides, like Nemesis Inferno, that's got some nice jungly landscaping around it. The theming for the Swarm, that's another prime example of good theming. They could do some good stuff with this if they overhauled the ride and give it a major overhaul. Same with Alton Towers, Conga River Rapids, that's a prime candidate for an overhaul, a major overhaul for an attraction. I think if Nemesis is getting overhauled at Alton Towers in the next year or two, Conga River Rapids and Jewel and rides like that, and maybe even Rita, is not too far behind for an overhaul or refurbishment, or removal even, with Rita's case. So, I think the Thorpe Park could do this with Rumba Rapids. I think there's nothing stopping them, and I think the Rumba Rapids will be a rapids adventure not to be missed if it gets overhauled. So that's two big rides to get overhauled or fully refurbished from the inside out. And I think Thorpe Park could do a really good job with both of them here. So there we go, I can finally breathe and not talk for much anymore. but there we go, that is talking about two major ride refurbishments that I could see Thorpe Park do. Dan Brown's Ghost Train and potentially Walking Dead the Ride. Rip it all out, combine the buildings together, build a new extended building at the back where X now stands, or Walking Dead the Ride now stands, and I would bring in this multi-dimensional indoor dark ride coaster experience to fill the void of Walking Dead when that goes. And, you know, Dan Brown's Ghost Train is an inconsistent ride. I'd keep the queue line, keep the building, extend it at the back where Walking Dead is in the pyramid section. Keep the pre-show section, but just give it a new storyline and give it a new theme. That is what I would do. And Rumba Rapids, again, overhaul, new storyline, new theming, new everything. It would be amazing. So there we go. So thank you very much, guys, for watching this discussion video. Thank you very much. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. And for now, guys, my name is Coast Shell, keep living the coast life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have a Thorpe-tastic day.